all the top job sites, and now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
We want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.
And now, it's time for the voice. Voice.
Don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal.
I want you to get up right now
and go to the window,
open it,
stick your head out and yell,
Hayden Bond! Top of the world!
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? The cult of personality. Dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. Like Mussolini and Kennedy. I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
Good Monday afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala. I am Tom Schmitz here on a wonderful Monday afternoon in the Brick City Beautiful, Ocala, Florida. Coming to you live from the palatial studios of WOCA, located at the Paddock Mall, just outside the food court. Had a great weekend over the weekend. Did some St. Patrick's Day celebrating. St. Patrick's Day is tomorrow. The Ides of March were yesterday, for those of you who listened in 11th grade English. And I stumbled across something yesterday. I must give credit to Jennifer, my girlfriend. I did not know this was on. She got it on demand off of HBO. And we started watching them. We hadn't watched the whole thing yet. But it's this 6-episode documentary about Robert Durst. And then last night, right before the 6th episode was set to air live, Robert Durst was arrested in New Orleans on a murder charge. He's accused of shooting writer and confidant Susan Berman, whose body was found in her L.A. home on Christmas Eve of 2000. He was in possession of a handgun when he was arrested in New Orleans, complicating his return to Los Angeles to face a murder charge. Durst, 71, is accused of fatally shooting Ryder and Durst confidant Susan Berman, whose body was found in her West Los Angeles home on Christmas Eve 2000. He was arrested in a New Orleans hotel lobby Saturday night. Dick DeGuerin, his lawyer, said Bob Durst didn't kill Susan Berman. He's ready to end all the rumor and all the speculation at trial. But we are frustrated because local authorities are considering filing charges here. Like I said, he was the focal point of a six-part HBO documentary, The Jinx, The Life and Deaths of Robert Durst. The final episode that aired Sunday evening wrapped up with a clip from more than 2 years ago in which Durst is heard in a bathroom mumbling to himself, "What the hell did I do? Killed them all, of course." Filmmaker Andrew Jarecki told Good Morning America on Monday that his team didn't notice Durst's bathroom ramblings for 2 years because the recording had no video and you're making a film. So there's no video of it. It's just him, his audio. And I'm not real sure that, you know, it's Durst. There's no proof it's Durst. It sounds like Durst. But anyway, but this story is riveting and I found out about it yesterday. Wonder if any of you, anyone out there in the listening area, has been watching this documentary. HBO did a very good job of it. The movie makers have done a great job. Andrew Jarecki did a great job explaining the story. It's like a six-part, you know how Dateline tells you a story in an hour? This is like six Datelines to tell one story. It's very compelling. I did not know about this story, and then after watching this documentary and then to find that he was arrested last night right as the final episode was about to air on HBO just puts another twist into this, and it just shows you that sometimes the best fiction in the world can't imitate real life. Because this is real life, and this is something Hollywood could have never made. I'm going to keep an eye on that. I also found out today by reading the newspaper that a new high-tech travel signal system is coming to Maricamp Road and Southeast 17th Street, which is great. Let's be honest. Maricamp is a pain in the neck to drive down during rush minute. I say rush minute because we live in Ocala. When you live in Atlanta like I did for a number of years, or you live in Chicago like I did, you know, you live in major metropolitan cities, they have rush hour. We have rush minute. But it's still no less frustrating. County portion of Maricamp includes Southwest 58th Avenue Baseline, Southwest 49th, that's near Forest High School, Southwest 44th. The new system at all three of those intersections are up and installed and under evaluation. The city's portion includes 14 intersections from Southwest 36th Avenue to State Road 200. And the new system about 6 months away from completion there, says Darren Park. He's the division head of the city traffic operation. It is listed in the most heavily traveled corridor of the TPO. About 33,000 vehicles travel daily on Maricamp from US 441 to Southeast 11th, and the same number from Southeast 25th to Southeast 36th. Only Interstate 75 and State Road 200 have higher travel counts in our area. And so now they put in a new traffic system. The new system, using mostly equipment made by Rhythm Engineering in Kansas, is called Adaptive Dynamic. When motorists enter and exit Forest High School at peak times, for example, the dynamic system senses actual traffic on all sides of the intersection, processes the information to give green light priority to the largest amount of vehicles, as opposed to fixed time signals. So now, the largest group is going to get the signal first. Technology uses a combination of processing computers, road sensors, television cameras, and Bluetooth-type wireless technology to react to real-time traffic flow and create a tunnel for platoons or groups of cars. So it's almost going to be like a traffic cop out there that can actually see where the biggest backup is and can help alleviate that by emptying traffic out of it. But it takes, like they said, it takes computers, road sensors, television cameras, and Bluetooth-type wireless technology. So while, yes, traffic will be eased, supposedly, there's also opportunity for Big Brother to know a whole lot more about what's going on. Traffic cameras, computers, road sensors, Bluetooth wireless. Sounds like a lot of opportunity for Big Brother, but it'll ease your traffic problems. Do you want easier traffic and more knowledge of Big Brother? You want less knowledge of Big Brother and sit in traffic more? I bet most of you would say, without even thinking, get me out of traffic. But it's a slippery slope, in my opinion, once Big Brother starts putting the cameras up. traffic backs up. You know, I know traffic backs up for like a mile or so, and you have to sit in traffic sometimes. I've traveled it before where I've left from here at the radio station and had to go to 36th Avenue to do trivia at Beef O'Brady's in the height of the afternoon at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, 5:30. It's a solid 20, 25-minute drive. And if that's all you have to face to drive home or to and from work, we are very lucky in this town. We'll ask Buddy Martin later today on the show when he gets here to the Voice of Ocala. I think he commuted 2 hours one way when he worked in New York City. I have friends of mine in Atlanta that live less than 20 miles from their job, and it takes them over an hour to get to work. We really don't have traffic problems in Ocala. We just feel like we do because we have nothing to gauge it against. But this is a good sign if you want traffic alleviated on Maricamp. But if you're afraid of what Big Brother may or may not see, this might not be a good sign. I don't know. After the break, we'll see what you think. Give me a call. Tell me what you think about the new traffic signal. Is it a good thing for Maricamp? Or is Big Brother, the sacrifice of giving up information to Big Brother, not worth good traffic? 622-9622. If you want to get in on that. Plus, this Bob Durst story is, I know it's fresh in my mind because I watched the documentary yesterday. But, I mean, this guy, and it seems like he's Teflon almost. He was indicted in Galveston, Texas, for killing and dismembering his next door neighbor. Ended up being found not guilty because of self defense. I don't understand. I was so confused at times watching this documentary, and then as we're getting ready to watch the last show. It breaks over the news wire that he's been arrested in New Orleans. Very, very surreal last night watching this documentary, finding out right before it came on that the guy that the documentary was about had just been arrested in New Orleans. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll take some of your calls, 622-9622, talk about this or whatever you might want to talk about on this Monday afternoon here on The Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Time now to spiff up your bling for spring. Make your rings look brand new. Our master jeweler at Goss & Son will rhodium finish your rings for just $69.95, regular price $75. It's like waxing your car. It brings that shine back and looks all brand new all over again. So come see us, our downtown location, Goss & Son Jewelers, serving you downtown for 65 years. Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such is the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer. In everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. Does osteoarthritis bring frustration with every step? Do pain and stiffness affect your everyday activities? If so, you may be interested in a research study for the treatment of pain associated with osteoarthritis. Rentstar Medical Research is conducting a research study of an investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 40 and 75 and who have been treated for the pain associated with osteoarthritis for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication. Compensation for time and travel will be provided. To learn more about this osteoarthritis study, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Again, that's 352-629-5800.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75 exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and the car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
Chip, you never cease to amaze me. What in the world are you building with all those sticks and cardboard?
Well, Mr. Marketing Guy, I'm making signs to announce the great lease offers at Ford Lincoln of Ocala and Village Ford of Bellevue.
Really? What do you plan on calling it?
Sign and Ride. Get it?
That's not how it works. Sign and Ride is all about fantastic lease offers on Fusions, Escapes, Fiestas, Explorers, and remaining 2014 Focuses.
Wait a minute. If I understand correctly, Sign and Ride would mean zero down payment?
Right.
Zero first month's payment.
Right again.
And zero due at signing?
Now you're on the right track. Don't waste time. Head to Ford Lincoln of Ocala and Village Ford of Bellevue today and see how easy it can be to drive off in America's favorite brand.
And if you're planning to buy a new Ford, 0% financing for 72 months on select new 2015 Fords.
Whether you buy or lease, now's the best time to head to Ford Lincoln of Ocala or Village Ford of Bellevue, your family of Ford dealerships where we've got what it takes.
Not all buyers or models qualify for sign and ride offer or 0% financing. See dealer for complete details.
Pay your taxes, eat your vegetables, watch your weight, mow the lawn, clean the house. We all have stuff we don't want to do. Isn't it about time you did something you wanted to do? Like getting your pilot's license? At Ocala Aviation, they make it fun and easy, and you can start by taking one of their Discovery flights. For only $99, you get to go up in the airplane with an FAA-certified flight instructor and actually fly the plane yourself. It's a perfect way to see if flying is for you. And once you get that ultimate feeling of freedom, Ocala Aviation can train you to get your pilot's license. Ocala Aviation also offers commercial flight training for those looking to make a career change and enter the world of commercial aviation. Ocala Aviation is conveniently located at the Ocala International Airport. So if you're ready to start your adventure, stop by or give them a call today. 861-7484. That's 861-7484. You'll be glad you did. I know I am. Ocala Aviation. Call today. 861-7484.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Monday afternoon. I am Tom Schmitz in the 3 o'clock hour. Buddy Martin joins us in the 4 o'clock hour. Great guest today as the Ocala Star Banner's editor of the editorial page, Brad Rogers, joins us. It's always a good time when Brad comes into studio. Buddy figures out some way to get Brad fired up, and a lot of times he doesn't have to. Brad's already fired up when he gets here. So Brad Rogers at 4 o'clock with Buddy Martin. There was an arrest over the weekend of a man who is accused of shooting two officers in Ferguson, Missouri. According to the confession of a 20-year-old man who said he pulled the trigger, I wasn't aiming at the police. Police Sunday charged Jeffrey Lee House Williams of St. Louis County in the shooting Thursday that seriously wounded two officers. According to a criminal complaint, Williams was in an older model Pontiac Grand Am just after midnight. He fired three shots in the direction of the police department. Two of the three shots struck officers standing in the police riot line. Prosecuting attorney Robert McCulloch told reporters Sunday afternoon that Williams claims police were not the intended targets. Williams told investigators he was involved in a feud at the time and had fired the shots in connection with a dispute. Prosecutor says, I'm not sure we completely buy that part of it. But there has been an arrest in the Ferguson police shooting, Ferguson, Missouri, where two officers were shot on Thursday. They have now arrested 20-year-old Jeffrey Lee House Williams of St. Louis County. So there seems to be some closure to that heinous and uncalled for shooting Thursday night of police as they were standing on riot line outside of the Ferguson Police Department. Checking the headlines again today. This from CNN Money. Crude oil dropped another 4% to a low of 42.85 cents a barrel on Monday. That's the lowest price since March of 2009. Millions of Americans who drive and watch gasoline prices creep up in recent weeks should be smiling. Oil was, everybody was talking about a comeback about a month ago, but I don't see that happening now because it's dropped 5 days in a row. It continues to drop. According to Tom Colosa, chief oil analyst at the Oil Price Information Services, I think the market almost has to have a $30 handle on it before it gets out of its system. So there's an expert thinking that it's going to go to $30 a barrel. That could cause gas prices to take another tumble, Colosa says, bringing the average U.S. price back to around $2 a gallon. It's right at $2.42 a gallon. The world still has too much oil. The supply glut that sparked a dramatic crash in crude oil in January remains. Oil settled in at $43.88 on Monday. There's been no pullback on production. OPEC hasn't scaled back production, and power player Saudi Arabia continues to say it has no intention of doing so. So they're flooding the market with supply, and demand is dropping. Economics 101 tells you when there's a lot of supply and little demand, less demand, prices fall. When there's little supply and lots of demand, prices rise. As we have cars that are able to go farther on a tank of gas, as more people are taking to bicycling to work or using public transportation, the demand for gas has gone down. The supply is, I mean, the United States, what they say, has a million more barrels of gas a day than it has a million more barrels of crude oil a day than it needs. That was not the case 5 years ago. And I'm okay with that. I need gas prices to be back down around $2, $1.79, $1.80. I think that's good. If we're spending less of our money on gasoline, we're spending it more on recreational stuff. I think that helps the economy. I know a lot of economists would say it's the other way around, but I don't think so. Lower gas prices means I'll travel farther to go on vacation. Lower gas prices mean that I'll travel maybe and pay for places that were out of my price range because of what I was paying in gas. Maybe I'll take a trip to Fort Myers instead of just taking it over to Crystal River because I can afford the gas. It helps the economy of the state. More people travel to Florida if the gas is cheaper. More people drive into the state if the gas is cheaper. Helps the economy of the state, I think, if gas is cheaper. And it looks like this trend is going to be around for a while, according to the experts that were quoted in this CNN Money story. I don't know if you missed it this weekend. We're going to talk about it a lot in the sports hour, but the brackets are out. The NCAA tournament, the brackets are out. But one game in particular I want to talk about. And I want to talk about it not for a sports reason, but because of the comeback story reason. Georgia State, that's a large commuter college up in Atlanta. They won the Sun Belt Conference tournament and clinched a berth into the NCAA tournament for the first time since 2001 in what was a putrid basketball game to watch, a 38-36 snoozer. And believe me, I watched every minute of it on ESPN2 yesterday, and it was an absolute snooze fest. Why might you ask, did I watch? Am I such a basketball fan, I'll watch a snooze fest? No, Georgia State beat, you know, Georgia Southern. But that's not what this story's about. On Sunday, the star of the game scored 18 points, second highest output of the season for him, was Kevin Ware. You might remember that name. That was the Louisville transfer. He was at Louisville when he suffered a gruesome leg break during the 2013 NCAA tournament. The kid that compound fracture broke his leg for Louisville in the 2013 tournament. We all remembered it was just a terrible, terrible leg break. Well, he came back and took to the floor yesterday, scored 18 of his team's 38 points. It wasn't but 38 points out there for his whole team. He scored 18 of them, and he's going back to the NCAA tournament after suffering that gruesome leg break. He's battled back and is going to be able to go back to the NCAA tournament. Hard work, determination, and a will to succeed is what Kevin Ware possesses. The fact that he transferred back to Georgia State, that's close to where he's from. He's from Atlanta, be closer to family. To battle back from that gruesome of an injury and have a game that good yesterday that propelled his team into the NCAA tournament, congratulations to Kevin Ware. The young man deserves it. We all felt for him when he broke his leg originally. And yesterday, even though Georgia Southern lost, I really wasn't that upset with it because of the story of Kevin Ware after what we'd seen and the comeback he made yesterday to lead his team to victory and get back in the NCAA tournament. So kudos to Kevin Ware. We're going to take a break. We come back. The Sunday night shows were on, but so were the Friday night shows. I want to talk about one show in particular that I like that is a reality show. Talk about that next. 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Here in Florida, when you're looking to go to the beach, you've got hundreds of options. Theme parks, no shortage of options there either. But when it comes to home insurance, most companies have only one option. Allstate is different. Here in Florida, Allstate agents offer home insurance options from several companies, so they can help you get the coverage that's right for you. And they'll help you save on quality car insurance, too. For starters, safe drivers save 45% with Allstate. So before you settle for just one option, talk to someone with many home and car insurance options. Your local Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hi, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. To get your quote, please call us at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations.
Allstate has no financial responsibility to you for any home insurance policy you purchase and would not be responsible for any claims. Allstate does not make any representations or accept liability related to operations of home insurance companies, including but not limited to their financial conditions. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
The next drink is on Dave Del Rio at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill. Just ask him for it. But don't wait. Show up soon because this offer isn't going to last very long. Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill will be filling up fast because their friends from the north are headed back that way soon. The good news is that seating is now available and Dave's buying the first drink. If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill and couldn't get in, now you can see firsthand what your friends have been talking about. Great food. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Great location. Check out those gorgeous sunsets over Lake Weir. Great people. Starting with Chef Dave Del Rio, who began his career in 1978. This spicy guy has been instrumental in opening over 100 restaurants. And he's buying you a drink. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, where there's little or no waiting these days. Come see what started out as Jay Eaton's dream almost 90 years ago. It's more awesome than ever.
Radio. I'm Pat O'Neill. Robert Durst has agreed to go back to Los Angeles to face a murder charge in the death of an ex-girlfriend. But in New Orleans, where Durst was arrested, his lawyer Dick DeGuerin says it could take a while.
We're frustrated because the local authorities are considering filing charges on him here and holding him here.
Durst also suspected in the 1982 disappearance of his wife. The suspect in last week's wounding of two cops in Ferguson, Missouri, says he wasn't firing at them.
An activist who spoke with 20-year-old Jeffrey Williams relayed the story that someone was trying to rob Williams in his car. He fired shots, but the bullets missed the unidentified robber and hit the two police officers. Even the activist who relayed the story doesn't believe Williams.
Fox's Mike Tobin. Doctors say an American healthcare worker who contracted contracted Ebola in Sierra Leone is in critical condition. He's being treated at the National Institutes of Health in Maryland. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Locally owned and operated since 1957, we are The Source, 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee. All for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit TurnerPest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Sunshine and nice this afternoon, high 85 to 87. Clear to partly cloudy tonight with patchy late night fog, low 60 to 63. Sunshine and pleasant tomorrow, high 85 to 88. Tomorrow night clear, low 61 to 64. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Jonathan Reed.
This weather forecast brought to you by Tri-County Generators, 1-800-622-1957. Don't get caught with your power down. Call Tri-County Generators now, 1-800-622-1957.
WOCA. AM
1370. 96.3. FM. WOCA. WWWWOCA.
If you want to avoid getting ripped off and put more money in your pocket, then join me, Clark Howard, every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA, The Source.
Visit the WOCA website at www.wOCA.com.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. I'm Tom Schmidt, soon to be joined by Buddy Martin. In the 4 o'clock hour, Brad Rogers, the editorial editor of the Ocala Star Banner, will be here joining us in studio on the Voice of Ocala as we come to you live from the WOCA studios at the Paddock Mall, right outside the food court of the Paddock Mall. I'm a big fan of one reality show. I don't like reality shows as a whole. Survivor, Dancing with the Stars, all these singing shows, Bachelor, Bachelorette, nah. But I really like The Amazing Race. And it seems like America does too. It led its spot with 18 to 49 year olds in the 8 o'clock time slot. And this one was especially good because you had to take apart a motor and find something in the transmission. It's very good how they keep it so fresh after 26 versions. This is the 26th season. They say season, but it is the 26th season, but they do two a year. This is the 26th version of American Race, the Amazing Race. And they always keep it fresh because they go to different countries all over the world and they make them do, force them to do different things. And this one was pretty good this week. They played snooker and they had to feed cats and they had to take apart a motorcycle. I'm not a motorcycle, a motor engine. And the team that was eliminated was one of the Backstreet Boys. Dadgummit, him and his boyfriend were eliminated. But there's still eight teams to go. I tell you, if you really want to watch a good reality show, in my opinion, tune in to The Amazing Race. And then you can't go wrong because Hawaii 5-0 comes on right behind it, and then the Blue Bloods come on behind that. It's a good Friday night of TV. The Amazing Race, Hawaii 5-0, and the Blue Bloods. Great, great TV watching. So if you get a chance, check that out. I did see, you know, I sometimes think Facebook is useless. And then I come across something like this and I say, this is where the social media outlet has its power and has its good for society uses. Somebody sent me a news report from, let me get the, from Channel 2, KATU. The KATU problem solvers. I don't know what city that's in. It's Channel 2. Maybe if some of you are familiar with KATU. But the problem solvers tested smoke alarms to see if kids would wake up to the alarm. And they set some kids up that had firefighter parents with fire alarms in the house. And about 12:30 at night, they went and set the alarms off. Now, remember, it only takes a short amount of time and a small amount of toxic smoke to kill somebody. So they set the alarms off. A 12-year-old and 9-year-old in the bedroom set the alarm off in their bedroom, took the 12-year-old about 20 seconds to wake up. Then it took the 9-year-old, the 12-year-old going over and shaking the 9-year-old, the 9-year-old rolling over in the bed wanting to go back. It was a full minute and 10 seconds before the second girl woke up and started to leave the room. Then I ran across another news report, and it's on Buddy Martin, Voice of Ocala. You can go to the Facebook page, Buddy Martin, the Voice of Ocala, and I posted it there. That shows a group of kids under the age of 8 where none of them woke up. They all slept through the smoke alarm for a good 2.5-3 minutes. And a study published in the Fire Safety Journal found that 85% of kids aged 6 to 17 did not wake up in similar tests. 85% of children ages 6 to 17 did not wake up to similar tests. And it's not just kids. The older and those with mild, moderate hearing loss are the most susceptible to not waking up to the alarm. That's quite a bit. 85% of children and didn't wake up. And then the older and those with mild hearing loss is also because the high frequency doesn't register with them. The article and the video I have posted on Ocala, on Buddy Martin, the Voice of Ocala, on the Facebook page, shows that there's a new alarm system that they're creating that it will be out on the market this year sometime, where parents can record their own voices saying, Margaret, get up. Margaret, the house is on fire. Get up, Margaret. Time to go out. The house is on fire. Or something along those lines. The same group of kids that they used that slept for over 2.5 minutes till their parents went and shook them and woke them up to leave all were up and out of their rooms within 20 seconds when they were hearing their parents' voice. So a new fire alarm that's being built shows that if your parents' voice is being used, you have a tendency to wake up quicker. And that's the key. Anything over a minute is too long in a house fire with the toxic smoke. I watched both these news articles. It was scary to me how easily the kids slept right through the alarm. I mean, one girl got up out of bed And then went back to bed. She got up. She said, turn the alarm off. Yelled, turn the alarm off. And turned around and got back into bed and pulled the covers up over her head. Because she wasn't fully awake. If you have that chance to get the smoke alarms that allow parents to record their own voices, we need to put those in all the houses, because research shows that kind of alarm may be able to get your kids moving more quickly. In one study, 100% of the children tested woke up when they heard a smoke alarm with their mother's voice. 100% woke up. Whereas the other test, 85% didn't wake up with the high frequency beep beep. All adults, if we're adults that have good hearing, we'll get up. That thing aggravates us, we'll get up. See right there, my phone's ringing. I'm out the door right now. But that's a scary total. 85% of the children tested did not wake up for the high-pitched alarms that most of our smoke alarms make in houses. Whereas 100% in a study woke up when they heard their mother's voice. Buddy Martin was there. I had Buddy Martin and he's gone now. Okay, well, Buddy Martin will call back. I had Buddy. I was going to ask him if that kind of message worried him about smoke alarms. So, Buddy Martin, give me a call back if you're out there. I had you for a minute and you were gone. But 100%, there's Buddy back. 100% of kids who heard their parents' voice on a smoke alarm woke up, while 85% of kids who just heard the high-pitched alarm didn't wake up. Buddy, I don't know if you've been listening to us, but that's a scary total with kids sleeping through smoke alarms.
That's a good story, because one of the problems you have to deal with is those toxic fumes, and they will kill you before the fire does.
Long before the fires do.
Time. Yeah. And that's a good story, and it's good for you for hunting it down and posting it on Facebook. That's a good idea about recording your parents' voices. I'm thinking about maybe putting a recorder in the control room for you when you nap off. Pop, get up, buddy. Pop, get up.
Well, that probably wake me right up. Probably wake me right up. Buddy, I heard Brad Rogers will be on the show. Are we just going to say, yes. Are we just going to say at 4 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen, Brad Rogers, and then just let him go?
Turn it on and just walk away.
Yeah, just walk away.
Pull it up, yeah. A couple of interesting things for Brad. He wrote a nice Sunday on the two young men who died, former football players. One, the Forest one, of course, Trinity. He attended, I think, the Juice Johnson funeral. He knew them both, and knew Juice, I think, more than others. So Brad will have that. And I want to ask Brad about the story about the editorial about the fact that the two fire stations are shut down because of lack of funds. And you talk about fires. We talked a little bit to the sheriff on Friday. I asked the cops about that issue. He, of course, faces the same thing where he might have to shut down but doesn't want to. Doesn't want to, because he said, the first thing that happens, what happens if somebody dies, and you couldn't get there in time and you shut down. So anyway, that's one thing Brad keeps on top of. We'll get his take on that. And then, of course, he's on the local scene. He's keeping up with what's happening in the city, the mayor. If you notice the paper of last week, Mayor Gwynn talking about his plan to remove the homeless from downtown to have open arms village. So all that. Of course, Tom, I heard you talking about the TV shows. I didn't hear what you discussed, but boy, I got something to talk about this week, including the puzzling plot to The Good Wife, which I have no idea
what's going on there. I saved Sunday for you and I. I talked about Friday. Amazing Race.
We'll talk about it. And I saw a movie. I saw two movies. One I saw at the Marion. I'm sorry, it wasn't the Marion. It wasn't on there. The second, Grand Exotic Hotel, which I'll talk about. Almost didn't get to see it because I couldn't tell from the sign, the abbreviation, if it was playing or not. All it said was the second best. They go, what is that? And then I saw a movie Saturday night. It just blew me away. On standard TV, that somehow I missed, that is really, really, I think, is a terrific movie. and the actress, I think she won the Oscar for her role. It's a sports movie, but it's not a sports movie, and it involves Clint Eastwood. You could probably guess what it is. It's a movie I think was just, I mean, it really, it was compelling, man.
That's even the first time you've seen, you know, first time you've seen that movie?
TV. So we'll talk about that.
Wow.
And of course, we have plenty of sports to talk about. The brackets, I haven't gotten into mine yet. We'll get Joe Williams taken, and of course, Franz Beard, all that coming up today on the program.
Yeah, buddy, and I didn't know if you saw, but Georgia State won yesterday against Georgia Southern.
I did.
But that's not why. That's yeah, Kevin Ware. Amazing story, yeah. Isn't it?
Yeah, and his coach got hurt in the celebration.
But yeah, hurt his leg really bad. Yeah.
Achilles, tore his Achilles tendon.
Right.
He said he was feeling sorry for himself a little bit, and he realized, well, look at Kevin Ware, what he went through with.
Yeah.
This is nothing, you know? And I guess it was a nice little moment there in that game where his son, the coach's son, Hunter, was at the foul line needing to make two free throws. And he walked up to his son and said, if you make, you know that new car you wanted, make these and I'll buy it for you. he says, I hope I didn't commit an NCAA violation, but he is my son, you know.
Right, exactly.
So that's a good story. Yeah. So there's always some good stories in it, but I'm having a little difficult time getting into the brackets. I'll tell you why coming up in Sports Hour.
Buddy Martin, set to join us in the 4 o'clock hour with Brad Rogers. Buddy, safe travels in.
See you, Tom.
We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap up hour number one, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on the Voice of Ocala, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on the Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, it's our business to make your business better. Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered as an unclaimed deal upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10. can for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. Wrapping up hour number one, I want to remind you, if you want to find some of these sports topics we talk about on Southern Pigskin tonight, you can always go to our Twitter account, SPigskin2NITE. SPigskin2NITE. As a matter of fact, I just posted up on Twitter that Tim Tebow worked out for the field, according to Adam Schefter. Former quarterback, Florida quarterback and 2007 Heisman Trophy winner Tim Tebow working out for the Philadelphia Eagles today. So, former Broncos and Patriots QB Tim Tebow working out with the Philadelphia Eagles, a source has confirmed. So, there's some news about Timmy. He's working out with the Philadelphia Eagles today. So, if you want to keep up with all the stuff that we talk about here on Buddy Sports Page and Southern Pigskin tonight, go to our Twitter account, SPigskin2NITE, for all our Twitter information. Follow us on Twitter. You'll get all four. If you miss Southern Pigskin tonight on the radio, you'll be able to go back and get those podcasts as we have those listed. If you want to get the podcast another way, go to WOCA.com. Click on Buddy Martin's picture when it comes up. It'll take you to the Voice of Ocala WOCA webpage. And then just scroll down until you get to a podcast, and it'll take you to the podcast page. Just a few more ways that you can continue to stay in touch with the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports page and Southern Pigskin tonight. Twitter, podcast, WOCA.com. Many ways to reach us and to get our sports stories right here on Southern Pigskin tonight and Buddy Sports page. So, the news today that I just posted up on Twitter, Tim Tebow is, according to Adam Schefter of ESPN, working out with the Philadelphia Eagles today. Chip Kelly probably looking for a backup to Sam Bradford. That's smart, being that Sam Bradford is often injured. So for all you Tebow fans, don't rush out and buy your Eagles garb yet. But it may be, you know, maybe something you start pricing Eagles jerseys and all, just in case they sign Timmy. Then you'll be able to get out and get your Tebow Eagles jersey. So you'll have Broncos, Patriots, and then Eagles Tim Tebow jersey. So keep that in mind. Coming up, hour two, Brad Rogers, the editorial editor of the Star Banner. He joins Buddy Martin right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local, The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris.
Guy Harvey Checking is now exclusively available at Gateway Bank. With Guy Harvey Checking, you will receive Gateway's premium checking account, plus several other Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation features, including membership to the Guy Harvey Hammerhead Nation, free Guy Harvey t-shirt, and an exclusive Guy Harvey debit card. At Gateway Bank, we will make a $50 donation to the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation for every new account opened. This is just one more reason why people choose Gateway Bank. Sign up today for your exclusive Guy Harvey Checking account with Gateway. Details available at gatewaybankcfl.com. Member FDIC.
Ooh, a xylophone. Sounds dreamy.
Yeah, they don't make them like this anymore, Robin. I'm shipping it to the Musical Historical Society.
And you're packing it like that?
What, this won't work?
Why don't you take it to the Personal Service Center at the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street in Ocala? Just look for the yellow signs.
Great idea. That'll save me a lot of time.
The passing of time.
Personal Service Center makes sending packages easy.
And quick. Call 789-6683.
For the Personal Service Center.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry. And we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at SuperiorAluminumDesign.com.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. White House spokesman Josh Earnest was asked to clarify comments made by the Secretary of State about re-entering negotiations with Syria.
He was referring to the fact that the Assad regime will have to be at the negotiating table with elements of the moderate opposition to try to broker an arrangement about the political transition in Syria.
Kerry told CBS that sooner or later the U.S. would end up talking to Syria about ending its civil war. Fox's James Rosen then asked about reports about the president's senior advisor leaking information regarding the Hillary Clinton email scandal.
A published report over the weekend in a leading New York newspaper asserted that White House counselor Valerie Jarrett played some role in the disclosures about Secretary Clinton's emails. Can you confirm that?
Yeah, it's utter baloney.
That report was in the New York Post. Boston breaks its own record for the snowiest winter, 108 inches. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Buddy Martin. Glad to be with you, joining the show in progress, Tom Schmitz, the first hour. And I am joined by our friend, who hadn't been here for a while, by the way. I thought maybe he got mad at me. I don't know. He's or hiding out or something. Or maybe he had an extended vacation, which, yeah, by the way, he would deserve if he took it, because he's worked long and hard here in the community. He's the editorial page editor of the Star Banner, a guy who kind of knows what's going on in the community. And he makes for a halfway decent talk show host, so we like to have him around once in a while. So, Brad Rogers, glad to have you back on the show, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
We didn't break up, did we?
No.
Okay,
no.
I just want to make sure.
Just been busy.
Okay, I just want to make sure we hadn't broken up or anything. Yeah,
There's a lot trying to go on in town.
You have a lot going on, but you know what? Hey, here's a good thing. Even though I went to a rant last week about my local, you know, circulation department of a newspaper, which I love my newspaper, by the way, you know that. But I know you're still standing over there, buddy. Wait a minute. Went into a rant last week.
Yeah, last week.
How about the last minute before we came on the show today?
Well, that was last week. That was nothing compared to last week.
Oh, no, last week you were really ticked off.
Yeah.
So, but I'm glad. I mean, thanks to guys like you, you're keeping the lights on and candles burning. And
absolutely.
I've said this before 1,000 times. I'll say it again. Internet is a miraculous thing, and we get lots of information and whatever. But internet site doesn't have a heart and soul. A newspaper does. And that's why, aside from the fact that I can't rap fish in the internet, you know, I love my paper. So anyway,
well,
glad to
that.
Have you.
Thank you.
Before we get into the subject of your column yesterday,
yes, sir.
Tragic thing happened in our community to two young men, which we talked about some on the show. You happen to have known them or known of them. Your son was of their age, and we'll get you to talk about that a little bit. Let's talk for a second about the piece, and I think I had my paper and threw it out, about the decision of the fire department, which is your editorial today, to close down
two stations.
Well, they didn't close two stations. They closed two squads. And that's
what's the difference?
Hard. Well, squads, they have squads.
The stations are open, but they have one fewer squad in each.
Well, these were special squads. Uh-huh. They were they were basically hazmat squads.
Okay, yeah. Well, there's something that's kind of
and
scary.
They just, frankly, it came down to having hazmat squads or ambulance squads.
Yeah.
They need a lot more ambulance squads than hazmat squads.
Yeah, well,
they're still available if they have a hazmat thing. But they're so shorthanded, buddy.
I know.
I mean, they're just so, I mean, they got 10% of their positions open. Over 10% of their positions.
And where's that money going right now, do you know?
Right now, I think they're paying a lot of overtime to try to fill the
Well, in your editorial page, you know, I mean, you talk about it on your editorial today, if I can ever find it here. But anyway, and the fact that
was it yesterday? Sunday, yeah.
Was it this day? Okay, so I got it mixed up.
That's all right.
I knew I read something.
They all run together.
Well, why don't you tell us what it says since you wrote it?
Well, what it says is that, you know, everyone's talking about the firefighter pay, and while you listen to the union and the union saying, oh, they're starting out firefighters $8.98 an hour, that is the starting wage. I looked at the actual pay list. There's three firefighters making $9.24 an hour. Everybody else is making more than that. But the real problem is that we can't compete with other communities. So when you got a paramedic who can go to Sumter County, for $10,000 more a year and doesn't even have to move, what do you think he's doing?
He'd be driving.
Yep, and that's what they're doing. And we're losing them right and left. And, you know, the strange thing is nobody on the commission really seems too worried about this. And when you sit down and look at the numbers, I mean, if the commission doesn't make some hard decisions this year, at the very latest, I don't think they can wait till next year, but maybe they can. I mean, you're going to be looking at in 3 years, a $10 million deficit. In 4 years, a $15 million deficit. In 5 years, a $20 million budget deficit in the fire department. And, you know, at that point, then you are closing fire stations, and you're not closing one or two. And, you know, buddy, you lived here in the days when, I did. You know, 20 years ago, our fire insurance rates were through the roof because we had no fire service. I mean, we finally got pretty decent fire rates. When they start closing fire stations, people are going to start screaming about their fire insurance rates. Not to mention, we're probably going to have people dying because the response times are going to be bad. And, you know, I had someone call me today, you know, a respected person in the community, asking about the county commission. I said, you know, he said, they actually want me to be harder on them. Which I found a little humorous because I'm not the only one that's hard on them, I think. And but they quibble over buying police cars. You know, they're quibbling over paying our firefighters. They refuse to pave roads. I mean, if you can't take care of your firefighters, your cops, and your roads, I mean, what can you take care of? And it's, there's no sense of urgency at all in dealing with this fire thing, and we're losing firefighters. And I don't get it. I just don't get it.
Well, they're going to have to raise taxes. They have done some of that for the schools. You're also
The voters, not the school board, not our elected leaders,
correct.
Who are supposed
voters,
to be,
right.
You know, they talk about doing the will of the people.
Right.
I mean, sometimes you have to do what's good for the community. And the voters finally recognize that, and that's how we got the school tax.
Right.
You know, no, nobody wants to pay more taxes. I don't want to pay more taxes. You don't want to be taxed.
You got
to
pay fire insurance
and
if
we
you
damn,
don't.
And we damn sure know Tom doesn't want to pay more taxes.
Hey, sure.
That guy.
I refuse to pay taxes. I move from house to house like nightclubs close when tax time comes up. I just move.
But yeah, nobody wants to pay more taxes. But, I mean, nobody wants to have, when they have a heart attack, they would like someone to show up and take them to the hospital. And, you know, I don't want to be, you know, scare tactics, but, I mean, our response times are taking longer. And minutes matter when you're having a heart attack.
We talked to another public official last week about this very thing of closing down squads, mm-hmm. and ultimately maybe the fire stations. Now, I know you had your moments with Chris Blair, and you've had a little tete-a-tete with him from time to time. But by the same course, he can show you mathematically where he's got, like, I don't know how much, $150,000, $80,000, or he's way under budget. Way under budget. It's almost like $2 million, $1.8 million or something under budget because he hadn't hired people. Mm-hmm. And he hadn't been able to hire people. And his response times are getting longer. And he's got situations that are looking pretty grim. His cars, you know, whatever. And we know Chris's story. Sometimes we think Chris, well, he's crying wolf and all that. But the fact is, it's the same kind of thing with the fire department. And the fact is, we're not paying our public servants enough money, number one. And now we're reducing the size of the forces. And I'm asking the people of Marion County, what do you want for a quality of life? And like you say, pretty soon it's going to be cutting into it in a serious way.
Right, right. And you know, Chris and I'll agree with this in terms of the sheriff's office. I was having lunch this several months back. I'm having lunch at a Subway, and I go in, and cops sitting at the table. There's cars running. I go, I'm thinking maybe just, he's used to hopping out of his car and leaving it run. I said, you know your car's running out there, right? He goes, yeah. I need to leave it run. I go, why? Something getting ready to happen? He goes, no. He goes, but if I shut it off, it won't start.
Yeah, that's what I thought was going to
happen. Yeah. Yeah. You know, and this is a guy that's on patrol.
Yeah.
I mean, this isn't some guy who's on his way to the, you know. And fire department's got a little bit of the same situation. Fire department, you know, we had a story about ambulances breaking down on the way to the hospitals, and it's, in fact, it's happening. But their problem is they've just had kind of a perfect storm. In the last 6 months, get this, buddy, 11 accidents that have taken ambulances out of commission. That's how. Now, folks, the big red thing with the flashing lights and the sirens, that's an ambulance.
When
it comes
to
an intersection and blaring its horn and siren, you're supposed to stop.
One of the worst things we do in this county, I've said this several times, is get out of the way of emergency vehicles.
Well,
you just don't get away from
it. I don't know whether it's kids with music too loud, or it's old people whose hearing aids aren't on, or whether it's
people
just
don't care. They're
or
late
people
for their
are
report.
On their cell
yeah.
phones, or
they're more important.
We've got 11 ambulances in the past six months that have been knocked out of commission.
Amazing.
And the problem is they have reserves. They have backups, but the backups are intended for, like, I got to take it in and have the water pump changed, or I need to go in and have the oil changed or the tires replaced. It isn't intended for it to be out to be a replacement for 30 or 40 days while another ambulance is repaired. So you've got that, but they've been spending the ambulance money because the county commission and it's. They've been shifting the ambulance
Robin
money.
Robin Peter again.
They've been shifting the ambulance money around so they can, you know, cut spending, and here we are. Yep. And it is what it is. Yep. And
all right, Brad Rogers is our guest, editorial page editor. He's on a rant right now.
Yeah.
At least I got off mine. You got on yours. But I want to come back and talk about two young men in this community who we lost in recent weeks, and it was not only sad and tragic, but it shook up a lot of people. And I know your family was friends with at least one of them, and did you go one of the wakes?
I went to Jesus Johnson's.
Yeah, and you knew him. So we come back, we'll talk about that, and we talked about on the show that how could this happen? You know, you're saying, how could this happen? And I've talked to a woman who is a psychiatrist at University of Florida who deals with students. I have her on the show here soon. And she told me some shocking things about what she's seeing out there right now. We come back, we'll talk about it right here.
Is there a possibility also that I may get Brad to clarify an editorial he wrote about a week ago or so? Because I'm a little confused about an editorial he wrote about a week ago.
No,
too.
Not.
Yeah, I'm a little
not
confused.
Enough time. All right, back after this timeout on the voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Time now to spiff up your bling for spring. Make your rings look brand new. Our master jeweler at Goss & Son will rhodium finish your rings for just $69.95, regular price $75. It's like waxing your car. It brings that shine back and looks all brand new all over again. So come see us, our downtown location, Goss & Son Jewelers, serving you downtown for 65 years.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Ocus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Ocus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
In a study involving more than 2,000 people, those with slimmer waistlines showed higher cognitive ability than those who were overweight or obese. Our pets improve our character and make us much better people. If your partner's the one who's stressed out, we know that you will be 25% more likely to be affected than a stranger would be. Yeah, be careful, because stress is contagious.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Don't get caught without your daily source of senior deals. Pick up your copy of the Senior Voice newspaper. It's your source for schedule and events tailored to seniors, with information you need, like a list of free events in the area. We even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company to you that fits your needs. And all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about them. For more information, call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223. And pick up your copy of the Senior's Voice at most any business up and down the 200 corridor.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
The most trusted name in news, Fox News. Every half hour, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
Back on the Voice of Ocala with Brad Rogers. And Brad, unhappy occasion this past weekend, but to celebrate the lives of two young men who tragically died in our community, and one of them a former player at Forest High School and University of Florida, actually both the University of Florida, and Juice Johnson, who played University of Florida and for Duquesne. I know you knew Juice better, mm-hmm. but you wrote a really nice tribute to the both of them on Sunday, and share your thoughts about that.
Well, first of all, they're the same age as my son, so it hit close to home, and my son came home for the funeral. as he said in a text to me last week, I wouldn't miss it for the world. You know, those boys, I mean, and I wrote my column, I mean, young, beautiful men. I mean, they were handsome young men. And everybody you talk to about either one of them was about how when they'd walk in a room or when they'd see you, they'd light up and make you just feel good. And they did. And I didn't know Danny Krasocka very well. I know Danny's family, and my son knew him because that's what football players do in this town. They know each other. And, you know, you just used a phrase to celebrate the life. You know, how do you celebrate a 20-year-old dying? How do you celebrate a 22-year-old dying? And, you know, I understand when you're our age, buddy. I hope they celebrate my life because I've had a great life. But it was just so sad. And, you know, I happened to sit next to a guy, and I feel like I know everybody in town, or if I don't know everybody, I can see why you're there. And obviously, Juice's family and his friends, they all kind of sat in one side of church, but this guy sat down next to me, and I had never seen him before. We sat there through the service, and all of a sudden, they were going through the speakers, and there was a fairly long list of speakers, and they called a guy's name, Jerry Schmidt. He was coach from Duquesne. This guy stands up and walks up there and gave a nice tribute to him and came back, sat down next to me, and after the service, I introduced myself, and I told him that I'd watched Juice grow up, and I said, "Do you have any idea?" And for those who don't know, Juice committed suicide on February 28th. And I said, "Do you have any idea why?" He says, "Brad, he was in my office the day before with his NFL papers." Because a lot of people thought he was despondent. You know, maybe, yeah. You know, here's a kid who had always been the best at whenever he went on the field. And he said, "No, he was in his office with his NFL papers, and he was preparing for pro day at Duquesne. And the scouts had been out looking at him. Kid was a gamer, and
what a great looking prospect! If you saw him on the hoof, a chiseled, bright smile, just a guy you loved him. Had positive. I didn't meet Juice, and I got a chance to know him a little bit. And he just kind of kid. You think, wow, he looks like a special young man. You know,
he's the only kid I'd ever seen, and I've seen other players that could do this, but they're far and few between, who with all his gear on, could stand flat footed. And do a backflip.
Yeah, and one of his former teammates, John Jalapio, said he used to ask him to do it every day for practice, and he did it every day. He used to get fired up watching him. So tough time. I mean, one was a suicide, the other was an accident. Apparently,
right.
I seen the young man who actually wound up his gun went off. Is really having a very difficult time too. By the way, obviously, with what after the killing of his friend, which who wouldn't, you know? And
right.
Just all the way around, and there's so many ways you go here, from, you know, from guns and we know down right. That road what's going to happen, and from there to youth, to trouble youth, but there's no evidence that we have trouble youth here, but there are a lot of trouble youth.
Yes, sir.
And I can tell you firsthand, but a friend of mine who is a psychologist at University of Florida, and counsels on a regular basis. You know her.
I know her.
Told me, I can't believe what I'm seeing out there right now. She says the worst it's ever been. More kids depressed. Don't know why. Don't know if it's because of the economic conditions at home. Not sure why, but they're more than she's ever seen. And, you know, this is and John Brantley, I talked to John about it, and John before the funeral, and John said, I just wish I could have been more proactive. Now, we always wish we could have done something, naturally, but he said there's something we can do to be more proactive, and I asked her that, and she said, well, there are a few things, you know, basically talking about things. But in this case, there was no evidence that depression was the reason that he took his own life.
You know, I want to do a shout-out to John, because I don't know how it is at the other schools, but and I will assume that most of the high school football coaches in this town do anything they can to help a kid. But I can tell you that at Trinity, when Brantley and Justin Wentworth were there, those kids never lacked for an ear, for someone will give them a hug for if they needed tough love. I have nothing but respect for John Brantley and Justin Wentworth. And
we're gonna miss them that we're having here. I miss John especially. Yeah. You know, not having him in the program.
You know, this you gotta think. I was talking to his mom, not last season, but season before last, and we were watching a game, and it was her 50th year. 50 consecutive years she had been going to watch John do something on a football field, either as a player or as an MCYFL coach or as a high school coach, but 50 consecutive years. And this fall, I mean, unless something happens that, you know, unforeseen, it'll be the first time in 50 years that John Brantley hasn't been on the football field doing something. That's an amazing record.
It is. You know, we were talking earlier, we've got about 30 seconds. Can you hang around for one more segment, by the
sure.
way?
Sure.
When Steve Spurrier came to Florida to coach for Doug Dickey as quarterback coach,
mm-hmm.
you know who his quarterback was?
John Brantley.
First couple of games.
I do just want to point out that John's son had a better record at Florida than John did.
Well, John got hurt. John got knocked down. John and Scott got hurt in the same game.
Yeah.
And John was a baseball player. Anyway, I thought that was interesting that Spurrier was his first quarterback. And
back to the boys.
Yeah.
Just what a sad, sad thing for this community. Mm-hmm. Both boys had unlimited promise, and the hurt that their families are feeling. I saw Juice's grandfather at the funeral, and I was good for the whole thing until I saw. I can't hardly even talk about it. Frank Mangione, what a great man. He was, what a great grandfather he was, and
raised Chris,
and the heartbreak that he must feel, I feel it for him, and leaned on a lot of chain link fences watching football games with him from Pop Warner on up, and my heart goes out to him, and you know, everybody, including I did in my column, you know, you ask why, you know, and as the one preacher said, some things we just aren't meant to understand, and
Just
how sad for those boys.
RIP to the families and their friends and what have you, and sad occasion. All right, hang around. Tom wants to ask you about one of your editorials, and we may have something else for you to do. Brad Rogers,
yes,
from the Star Banner. More of him after this timeout on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Does osteoarthritis bring frustration with every step? Do pain and stiffness affect your everyday activities? If so, you may be interested in a research study for the treatment of pain associated with osteoarthritis. RentStar Medical Research is conducting a research study of an investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 40 and 75 and who have been treated for the pain associated with osteoarthritis for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication. Compensation for time and travel will be provided. To learn more about this osteoarthritis study, please call RentStar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Again, that's 352-629-5800. Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs.
proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. White House spokesman Josh Earnest was asked to clarify comments made by the Secretary of State about re-entering negotiations with Syria.
He was referring to the fact that the Assad regime will have to be at the negotiating table with elements of the moderate opposition to try to broker an arrangement about the political transition in Syria.
Kerry told CBS that sooner or later the U.S. would end up talking to Syria about ending its civil war. Fox's James Rosen then asked about reports about the president's senior advisor leaking information regarding the Hillary Clinton email scandal.
A published report over the weekend in a leading New York newspaper asserted that White House counselor Valerie Jarrett played some role in the disclosures about Secretary Clinton's emails. Can you confirm that?
Yeah, it's utter baloney.
That report was in the New York Post. Boston breaks its own record for the snowiest winter, 108 inches. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Howdy, folks. RL here for Dairy Queen, wishing you everyone a happy, happy new year. And to start it off right, you need a hot, juicy, char-grilled bacon cheeseburger, fried drink, and a sundae for just $5. Or try our famous chicken strips or wraps. Nobody offers all this quality and value but Dairy Queen. And this offer's good till 4 p.m. every day at Dairy Queen Silver Springs, where we always treat you like kings and queens.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Calista Redmond, a veteran trailblazer and a technology leader, speaking about the open power server technology and how it is changing the world.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events served bite-sized.
Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin will be in the studio in the garden with Carol, taking your calls about your lawns and your gardens.
Have all of your real estate questions answered by Bob Kennedy on Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty with Bob Kennedy.
And then Joe Reichel from Damage Control Services will be answering your questions about your do-it-yourself home repair projects.
Seth Posner will be in the studio. He's the owner of AA Lock Dock and Security, security systems for businesses and individuals.
All of that, plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Back in the voice of Ocala, we've handcuffed and tied up the editorial page editor, Brad Rogers. I often say we could have better shows if we had the open mic during the commercial breaks, because all the good stuff happens then. Reminiscing about newspaper stories, Brad, Tom has got to ask you this question. He'll moan about it all night if you didn't get it in. So let him ask you this question, and let's see if we can come up with a lighter topic after this. Okay, go ahead, Tom.
Well, Brad wrote an editorial I'm trying to pull it back up here because my internet went out. It was published March 7th on a Saturday, and it talked about repealing Florida's ban on retail stores like Walmart, Walgreens, Publix, Winn-Dixie from having liquor being sold in their stores because they already sell beer and wine. And on the surface, what seems like a dumb law, and you pointed it out, that it seems kind of ridiculous that Winn-Dixie and Publix have to go to the point of even buying retail space as close as they can to their stores that are separate entities to sell these things. And I thought, while it sounds like a good idea on the surface to have more opportunity, what would that do to the mom and pop shops in town here? Because we have quite a few mom and pop liquor stores. Now, you seem to be in favor of the retail stores having the access to sell liquor. Don't you think that might curtail, because of the ability to buy in volume that the retail distributors could buy, it would hurt mom and pop shops in the long run?
Probably.
It's keeping Tom up nights.
It probably hurt him.
On the surface, it sounds like a good idea that retail stores, for the convenience of it.
Mm-hmm.
But we got a lot of mom and pops here in Ocala. Now, in a city like Jacksonville or Miami or something, I don't think it would be that important. But a city like Ocala, there's quite a few mom and pop liquor stores here that would
ABC,
be hurt by that.
ABC says the same thing, that it'll be, that they won't be able to compete with them because it'll be one-stop shopping. And I don't know. The argument is that ABC is going to specialize and have more specialty items, and so I don't know. Yeah. But I don't know that you should say to Publix and to Walmart, you can't sell liquor when they're already doing it. I mean,
they're selling beer and wine. They're selling alcohol. I get the gist of that.
Publix I see has a liquor store next to it,
and now the Winn-Dixie, which used to be Sweet Bay, has one.
I mean, I'll stand by the editorial.
Now, does that say more about Brad Rogers' buddy that he wrote this editorial? The only time he gets my attention is when he writes about liquor.
Probably says something about you. More than likely, something about you.
All right, what are we going to talk about? Light.
I'm going to ask you about. Well, I'm going to get you to play Faker Factor, but here's something I want to talk about. Trains.
Yeah.
Slowly, I've watched as we redevelop into a transportation center, and that's who we are. We talked about this 100 times. About this is what we've been for hundreds of years, basically,
right.
And we know FedEx and all the other things. Now, and shipping is going to be a big business for us. And now we have all these trains coming in.
Mm-hmm.
We now have, I believe, 7 more trains a day. Last time I counted, maybe that's more. Maybe it's more now. Mm-hmm. And I said at the time, that's odd, you know. And then I found out the reason why is because of the Orlando, of the high speed. We had to take all the freight, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, well, what does Ocala get out of that? What does Marion County get out of that, for crying out loud? Why are we paying for the high speed rail in down in Orlando? You know, like sort of dumped it off on us. And you say it's not a big issue, but I have now run into situations several times where I've been blocked by trains. One time, the train they were working on the track and it was broken down, and I couldn't get to see a woman. A mother was sick of a friend of mine. But I mean, that's one case. My question is, if it does become a problem, and we do see accidents, and we do see more trains, and we do see more traffic being held up, the railroad kind of is like a czar. They do anything they want to do, and nobody, CSX doesn't answer to anybody, apparently. Can you put this on your calendar to look into, please, Mr. Editor?
A little history. When that deal went down, we knew we were, in fact, I think we were the paper that broke that. This goes back to Jeb Bush days. Mm-hmm. That's how far back we go. And Jeb had been working this little deal with the Sunrail over in Orlando, where essentially they were going to give CSX that rail. And when all this went down, our concern was what was in it for Ocala. Larry Creedle, from Ocala,
yep,
was the Speaker of the House.
Right.
And we beseeched him, please make sure we get something out of this.
Yeah.
And we got like one overpass is what we got out of it. And so to answer your question, I guess the thing we got out of it is that I guess the thing that we got out of it is that when they redid the highway, the railroad, essentially what we got running past us right now is an interstate railroad highway.
Mm-hmm.
And we're smack dab between Tampa and Jacksonville. And this I do know. There's only two places between Jacksonville and Tampa that are suitable for a place to pull trains off of.
Mm-hmm.
We're one of them, and Wildwood is the other. And there's just nothing in Wildwood, quite frankly.
It's always been a railroad town.
Huh?
It's always been a railroad town.
Yeah, but there's nothing there in terms of industry at this point.
I understand.
And so I guess what we're going to get out of it is hopefully this select site, the CSX select site, and CX's interest in the 489 property will be parlayed into something meaningful, and maybe we'll become an inland port.
Whatever happened to that dream? That thing's long gone.
It's still out there.
The guy here, they're going to bring in stuff at the port, and you got to split a rail line up and bring it up to the...
They got to get the Panama Canal open, too. I mean, part of it is bringing those bigger tankers through.
Can't you get that done? By the editorial or something?
Yeah. Talk to Rick Scott, and we know how responsive he is to the people's will.
Yeah, so. I want to send him a note about that comment about global warming, too, by the way.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
Okay. All right, look, I've been hard on you today. I've grounded it out of you. I told you I was going to keep you just for a minute. I said I'd just keep, let you go.
You lied.
But I did lie. And now I'm going to have you play a little game. We have to do this. But Tom, he gets bored, so we have to bring in and subject our guest to this so he has something to do.
I beat him last time I was here, and I wasn't even trying.
We're going to start
giving out. I don't recall that.
We were going to give out T-shirts. I beat the Terminator, but we couldn't afford it.
Yeah, because we'd give away too many shirts.
You're paying Tom too much.
Well, that's for sure.
Boy, you set a mouthful then.
He makes it more than I do. So here we go. We're going to play. You ready to play? You want to play this little game of
sure.
Fake or Factoid? Okay. All right. If we could have the producer get the little music sound up. Thank you. Here we go. Fake or Factoid, America's favorite game. Soon to be syndicated with Jeopardy! Wheel of Fortune. With Brad Rogers as host. Today's questions, fake or factoid. Number one, guest goes first this time. A woman's sense of smell is stronger than a man's. Fake or factoid?
Factoid.
Yeah, I'll go with fact.
Both say fact. Both correct. Number two, men see better than women at night.
Fact.
Fake.
Tom says fact. Brad says fake. Brad Rogers goes up by one. It's fake. Number three, the youngest marriage recorded in the world was ages 10 and 9 by a Peruvian tribal prince and his first cousin.
Fake.
Fake.
Both say fake. Anybody want to change their answer? Okay, you're both correct. Brad leaves by one.
It was now, much younger than that, I thought.
I thought it was some Chinese or Mongolian.
I have no idea. I just made that up. Number four, I almost said Chinese, by the way. Number four, men who kiss their wives in the morning live 5 years longer than those who don't.
Fact.
I'll go factoid.
Both fact. Both correct. And now, Tom, you got to go the opposite here in order to have a chance to tie, because you're down by one.
Yeah. Well, I've been nice to Brad and went first both times.
Then you let Brad go first. Number five, hugging extends a person's life by 1.6 days a year.
Oh, factoid.
Fake.
Tom goes fake. Brad goes factoid. And it's a tie game.
Yeah.
It's fake. Here we go. It's fake. I made it up.
How many days does it extend?
I don't know, but I just know it's not correct because I made that up, so I can tell you that. Finally, the number. Let's see how close you get to it. You have to write this down real quick and don't say anything until I ask you. Think about large number. Elwood Edwards did the voice for AOL, the sound files. You Got Mail. He is heard how many times a day? How many times a day? It's in the millions. Elwood Edwards did the voice for AOL Sound Files. You've got mail. He has heard about how many times a day. The winner of the number wins today's match.
All right.
Let's put your numbers up. Doesn't matter who goes first. Tom says, how many? I can't read it.
61 million.
61 million, Tom says.
It's a 23.3 million.
23 million? The winner is Brad Rogers. 27 million times a year. A day. I got it right. 27 million is the answer. There you go. Brad Rogers wins the match.
Again.
It was fixed.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
Pick up your T-shirt. I'll be the Trivenator. I'm sorry without those. Hey, Brad, it's good to have you on the show, man.
I appreciate it.
Appreciate your work. Appreciate your time. Thank you. Come back soon.
Yes, sir.
Brad Rogers, editorial page editor of the Star Banner. Time out. Come back and talk about The Good Wife, among other things, and the Sunday night TV shows and a movie I just love this past weekend right here on the Boards Book Out.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball.
Guy Harvey Checking is now exclusively available at Gateway Bank. With Guy Harvey Checking, you will receive Gateway's premium checking account, plus several other Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation features, including membership to the Guy Harvey Hammerhead Nation, free Guy Harvey t-shirt, and an exclusive Guy Harvey debit card. At Gateway Bank, we will make a $50 donation to the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation for every new account opened. This is just one more reason why people choose Gateway Bank. Sign up today for your exclusive Guy Harvey checking account with Gateway. Details available at GatewayBankCFL.com. Member FDIC.
The next drink is on Dave Del Rio at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill. Just ask him for it. But don't wait. Show up soon because this offer isn't going to last very long. Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill will be filling up fast because their friends from the north are headed back that way soon. The good news is that seating is now available and Dave's buying the first drink. If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill and couldn't get in, now you can see firsthand what your friends have been talking about. Great food. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Great location. Check out those gorgeous sunsets over Lake Weir. Great people. Starting with Chef Dave Del Rio, who began his career in 1978. This spicy guy has been instrumental in opening over 100 restaurants. And he's buying you a drink. Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill, where there's little or no waiting these days. Come see what started out as Jay Eaton's dream almost 90 years ago. It's more awesome than ever.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Hello, gorgeous.
Hi, this is Becky at Hello Gorgeous Salon. We are located in the heart of downtown Ocala, right next to the historic Marion Theater. I'd like to invite you to stop by and see our new boutique area and meet our staff of professional stylists. Here at Hello Gorgeous, we are ready to update your look with the latest trends. It's the perfect time to brighten up your look. So make your appointment now for those highlights and Brazilian blowout. But don't stop there. We are a full-service salon offering manicures, pedicures, and facials also. So if you've been searching for a salon to call your own, come and see us at Hello Gorgeous Salon. We are located at 48 South Magnolia Avenue in downtown Ocala, right next to the Marion Theater. So call today and set up your appointment at Hello Gorgeous Salon at 351-5358. That's 351-5358. And don't forget, we also do men and children's cuts too. 351-5358.
Hello Gorgeous.
You've got
Got a Garden, and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
We are The Source, WOCA, news, talk, sports, and more.
So, cut off my shows last night. I've got to where I can work pretty good, work on this book project, and also watch TV. Sometimes very boring television. But anyway, I'm really having a hard time following The Good Wife. I don't know what's going on there. It seems like the writers and directors are lost. They, you know, I'm a little over this state's attorney's race thing and all the stuff going on around it, and the love interest seem to go back. I mean, it's just too much going on. Mr. Canning in the hospital. I mean,
the whole Canning thing. I don't know where that's going.
Yeah, I'm a little tired of that.
Michael J. Fox. It was great. He was a good oddity. Get rid of him now.
Yeah, and you know they miss Josh, and they don't have any clean, clear storylines, you know, anymore. So they're just all over the place.
The campaign managers, the love interest.
Of course, we're all waiting to see what's going to happen there. And anyway, Alicia disappoints me just a little bit. She's sold out.
Be honest though. Madam Secretary got you last night.
Madam Secretary, I like.
It's a good show,
and it's becoming. It has become one of my favorite shows.
I mean, it was.
She's terrific.
It was great with the coup in Iran and everything. I mean, it was riveting.
And there's a frame of reference here because she has a home life, a family. You identify a husband, you know, whatever. And she's divided, split between her country loyalty and her job and her mother. And she's a very good actor. And he's pretty good too. They have a good cast now.
Tim Daly's a good actor.
Yeah. Good job. So anyway, I wanted to mention the movie that I saw, and I just wasn't much on it. I was flipping around.
Finally watched The Unforgiven with Clint Eastwood.
Yeah, right.
Morgan Freeman, Clint Eastwood.
You know, Clint Eastwood, by the way, is having a pretty good year. I went to see the second best Grand Exotic Hotel Friday night. Second best exotic Grand Marigold Grand whatever.
You went and saw the first one and loved it. So how was the second one?
The second one was good. I'm glad I saw it. There was, of course, Judy Dench and Maggie Smith. You can't beat them. They're terrific. And, of course, we had a new person come along and joined us. Dev Patel, I still like him best of all because of my TV show about the TV show. Richard Gere shows up and was okay. He added something to it. But once you've got that drift of what that hotel is, what it's about, it's kind of the same repeat. It started really slow. It picked up momentum. Entertaining movie. I'm glad I saw it. But if you're over 60, you'll enjoy it more. I want to say though, how could I have missed Million Dollar Baby?
I have no idea.
I mean, smashing performance by Hilary Swank. And by the way, Clint Eastwood, Morgan Freeman, not so bad either.
You know, Clint Eastwood directed the movie. He starred in the movie.
He was good. One of his best roles.
And there was some golden doll given to Hilary Swank for the movie.
Yeah, I understand. But she was great. I mean, she was really awesome. She was believable. Really believable. I mean, and then it became one of the best movies I've ever seen and one of my top sports movies.
It's got to be one of your top sports
movies. It really wasn't a sports movie, but it was just a boxing setting. It was about the human condition.
Right. Yeah. But when you go and talk sports movies, it never gets its just due.
It needs to be in there.
And it's one of the best sports movies you ever see.
Yeah, it's really good. So I enjoyed that thoroughly and was glad I got a chance to catch up. There's other movies on it. There's a lot of good movies out there. But I'll tell you one thing, when you go, and I'll go to the Marion first, but I had to go. I went over to the 16 theaters, and we made a mistake. We can't find the movie. And we kept looking over the grid at the time, and it said, second best. I said, what is second best?
Second best exotic marigold.
Yeah, when you tried to read that on a marquee when you're in line. Anyway, all right, coming up next, it's Buddy's Sports Page. We will talk about the brackets, having a hard time getting into them. Joe Williams will join us, France Beard, all coming your way with the sports news right here on Buddy Sports Page. Stay tuned.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Real estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed, but never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field, and now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service, and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 840-0750. That's 840-0750.
WOCA.
Your source for the number one sports weekend, Fox Sports, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
This is WOCA, News Talk 1370.
We are the source, WOCA.
It's the end of the fiscal year, and that means budget cuts and number crunching. Now's the time of the year you're evaluating your expenses, planning your budget, and finding ways to save money and increase efficiency to maximize profits. Dex Imaging understands and delivers. Call Dex Imaging today for a free document management evaluation. Cutting your office expenses is as easy as calling Dex Imaging, 352-266-0333. Start saving money today and increase your bottom line with Dex Imaging. Printers, copiers, and fax machines that increase office productivity and save you money. No one understands your bottom line better. Call Dex Imaging today, 352-266-0333, or check them out on the web at deximaging.com. That's DEXImaging.com, or call 352-266-0333 for your free document management evaluation today.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Let's give it up for old asphalt and a new pair of shoes. Let's give it up for a good rhythm meeting a sweet melody. For a church cookout under clear skies. Let's give it up for good things coming together, like bundling your auto and other policies together with an Allstate agent, which can save you time and keep you better protected. Let's give it up for good.
To receive your comparative insurance quote, contact the McDonald Agency at 622-2333.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida Basketball on WOCA The Source.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says there will be no final vote on Loretta Lynch's nomination to be the next Attorney General unless Democrats help pass a measure that fights human trafficking.
There's not a single legitimate question that has been raised about her aptitude for this job. Instead, all we've seen is a bunch of political obstruction from Republicans.
White House spokesman Josh Earnest, Senate Democrats say the bill in question contains anti-abortion language and they won't vote on it till it's removed. Robert Durst, the Realty heir, suspected murderer and subject of an HBO serial about his life, is under arrest. An open mic caught him admitting to his crimes.
Durst waived his right to an extradition hearing and through his attorney said he is eager to go to Los Angeles.
Fox's John Roberts, Durst is wanted for murder in California. Wall Street had a good day. The Dow closed up 228 to finish at 17,978. The NASDAQ was up 58. The S&P climbed 27.5. Fox News. We report. You decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
How much time? 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho.
And now it's time for the Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now, here's Buddy.
Welcome to a Monday edition of Buddy Sports Plays. Glad to be with you here from our studios here in the Paddock Mall. It is March Madness. Well, it's March. A little bit of the madness may have been taken out of March by Kentucky, a team that looks like, while not invincible, certainly a tough team to beat. We saw that in the SEC tournament. And they finished unbeaten, and they finished convincingly. A couple of close calls earlier in the year, overtimes, what have you. But this team, it looks to me, I think you have to go back to the days of the late 50s, to the great Kentucky team. I would say, at least, the teams I saw, Frank Ramsey, Cliff Hagan, Lou Sirapoulos, that great team of, I believe, 57 or 6 national champions. Saw them play in Florida's gym. The 2012 team, a lot of people are saying, is just as good as this team. I don't necessarily think that's the case. But the 2012 Kentucky team did get it done, so you have to give it credit. But just on the hoof, this Kentucky team looks awesome. They look like they're unbeatable. The question is, can Duke survive and give them a game? That's what people want to see. They want to see Duke, Kentucky, the 4 seeds, Tom, Kentucky, Villanova, Duke, and Wisconsin. Wisconsin probably a team that might be, if such thing, if a number one seed can be a dark horse, I think Wisconsin. It wouldn't be a bad pick. I don't think they can beat Kentucky, but they could give Kentucky with Jaminski and that front court they got. They might give Kentucky a little bit of a battle. So
Kentucky out of the one seeds would probably give Kentucky the better battle than any of the other three one seeds. I've watched a lot of basketball this year.
Kentucky give Kentucky a battle?
Wisconsin.
Oh.
Out of all the one seeds, Kentucky, Wisconsin down low, because they have a mean bully type way they play down low, and they can shoot from the outside. They can play inside and outside. Okafor, I think, he's going to he's been shown from Duke that he can be pushed off the block a little bit, and the way William Cauley-Smith and him play, I think Duke doesn't match up near as well as Wisconsin does. But a team that nobody's talking about that I've watched through the ACC tournament, and you know, I haven't seen many people say that they're going to have a shot. They're a three seed, but I bet Notre Dame would match up very well against Kentucky because they can shoot, they can score, there's players that can get their own shot, and they are big down low and sure not scared to bang it up.
In the ACC, they knocked off Carolina
North Carolina's
Duke,
rear end.
And Duke, and they didn't. It wasn't even close. So.
No.
I didn't see that team coming.
I watched the entire ACC tournament, and Notre Dame was just amazing. Because they can do it all, buddy. They can shoot from the outside. They got good ball handlers. They play great defense. And they're not afraid to get down there and put a shoulder into you or hip into you on the low block.
Yeah. Well, of course, the round of 64 underway on Thursday with the playing games, of course, prior to that. But it doesn't feel like, and I talked to Joe Williams about this Friday. or what day was it last week we talked to Joe?
Wednesday.
And he's having a hard time getting into it, too. It just seems like there are some good stories. You mentioned one for the first hour, Kevin Ware, the Louisville player who destroyed his leg and then, of course, had to leave school, came back in Georgia State, a Cinderella team, but probably not going to get there. But a good story nonetheless. And there'll be some good stories that will pop up, and I'm sure it just feels like maybe it's because Florida's down this year. We're not following as closely, perhaps, as we normally do. It feels like that there's, I know, except for the state of Kentucky and the big blue nation around the country, I think there, and of course Notre Dame, naturally there's always a lot of fire in their bellies. But it just feels like it's not a great year for basketball. Certainly taking nothing from Kentucky, it looks like a great team. So anyway, having said that, Tom has the news. We'll check in with Franz Beard here in a few minutes to get his take on the brackets. I hadn't even started to look at the brackets. I don't know. I know the four seeds. I know a couple of games. Quite frankly, I probably won't get into picking the brackets until maybe, if I do them at all, till Wednesday. I don't know. I'm just saying. But then, of course, Joe Williams will wrap it up here on the other side of the bottom of the hour, and we'll get his take on a little basketball as well. So, golf. Some of the best golf I've seen this year played this past weekend at Valspar. It was a terrific performance in the playoff they had. And you could see the future of golf, Jordan Spieth being the one who won that thing. But some great golf played with the foursome coming up the final stretch and in the playoff. And certainly Sean O'Hare, who hadn't been around, hasn't won in 4 years, lost his game, lipped a putt out that would have given him the victory. Then Patrick Reed made a couple of phenomenal butts getting on the stretch, and I'll tell you, it was some really good golf. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It's the best golf I've seen played since last summer, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. So
I believe that Jordan Spieth kid, we're always looking for the next Tiger, the next Jack, or the next this. You're not going to get the next one of those because they transcend the sport. I mean, everybody's looking at Rory. I believe the next good competition in golf maybe Roy McIlroy, who's 23 years old, and Jordan Spieth, who's just above 21. These two kids look like they got a long, good time. They'll both be at Arnie's tournament this week. They both look like they can play this game for a long time at a high level. Maybe this is the versus competition we're looking for to drive the sport.
And O'Hare's going to be there, too, by the way.
he shows me he's fully back from the way he fell off.
I mean, he's a guy who's a lot of game now.
I know. Sean O'Hare's got a lot of game.
And he lost his game. He's back, and he's got a lot of game. But Spieth has got everything plus the it factor.
Right.
He's a good-looking kid. He's daring. He makes shots in the clutch. He plays with passion. He makes some phenomenal shots. He's aggressive. All the things we like in a golfer. And I'm not saying he didn't have to be the next Tiger, but he certainly gives us a little bit of hope for the future of the tour, which, by the way, for the first time in a long time, I've even gotten interested in golf.
Well, remember, we had Jack and Arnie. We had Nick Faldo and Greg Norman as competitors.
You're forgetting about Trevino, by the
way. We had Trevino. I know the golden era of golf, but I'm talking about when you look at marquee matchups. You had Nick Faldo and Greg Norman. You had Tiger Woods and Phil Mickelson. You always need that antagonist type deal, and I think the next one in line may be Rory and Jordan Spieth.
Could be. Yeah, we'll see.
Because Rory McIlroy is the best golfer right now in the game. And Jordan Spieth looks like he could give him a little run for his money.
And who's world number one?
Rory McIlroy.
Yeah, and I'll see how long he holds it.
Yeah.
Okay, Tom, what's the headlines here?
Well, buddy, you mentioned the NCAA brackets. They're out. Kentucky, Villanova, Wisconsin, and Duke were the top seeds. The number two seeds in each region go to Kansas, Arizona, Gonzaga. Nobody's talking about Gonzaga. And where's my other number two? Virginia, who lost its number one seed by losing to North Carolina in the semifinals. So a bracket that looks like it's going to line up to be a pretty good bracket, but I'm with you, buddy. I'm not even going to worry about it until probably Wednesday. Just not that into it. Rob Manfred is reconsidering a reinstatement request that has been submitted to him. Are you ready for who it is?
No.
One Pete Rose has requested reinstatement back into Major League Baseball, and Rob Manfred says he's going to give it a serious look. Representatives for the former Cincinnati Red legend have asked him to lift the lifetime ban, and Manfred says, you know, maybe it's time to look at it a little more closely. So I don't know how you feel where it comes down on Pete, buddy, but keep the manager that gambled out of baseball out of the hall, but the player who has more hits than anybody else should be in the hall, in my opinion.
Well, his record's in the hall. He's just not in the hall.
Right. But the player should be, the manager shouldn't be. And I don't know how you juggle those two. Damaris Smith wins re-election as NFLPA. He earned another 3-year tenure as executive director of the NFL Players Union after winning election on Sunday night in Hawaii, where player representatives from 32 teams voted to keep him. The incumbent had defeated the field and included an unprecedented 8 other candidates, including former NFL players Sean Gilbert, Robert Griffith, and Jason Belser. So, Damaris Smith, this comes as a surprise to me because I don't think he's done very much to bolster what I feel is the weakest union in all of the union in all of sports. I think the NFLPA is probably the weakest of the unions. And I think Damaris Smith hadn't done a whole lot to help him strengthen that.
Caved into the owners a lot.
He has a lot. And finally, all you Tim Tebow fans out there, Tim Tebow working out with the Philadelphia Eagles today, buddy. You know, he played for the Denver Broncos, played for the New England Patriots. Now he's working out with the Eagles. Chip Kelly signed Sam Bradford, and, you know, might need a backup that can run that kind of spread offense, and because Bradford is often injured in his career. And I would think it's tailor-made for Tebow, this offense. And if he's really sharpened his throwing like Tom Brady's quarterback coach, who Tim Tebow's been working with, said he has, this may be fruitful for all you Tim Tebow fans out there that want him to make it to the NFL.
I don't know how I feel about that. I wish Tim all the best and all that. He was a great player in college. He probably could have had a shot if he got with the right team, right coach. It may be too late now. But it costs him no more than a free agent to look at him in camp.
And he's pretty good, by the way, he's pretty good in a coat and tie behind the desk on Saturdays on the SEC Network.
He's done a lot better at broadcasting than I thought he'd do.
Right.
And I think he's got a future there if he wants to take it. Tebow's got a future, probably a lot of things, if he wants to do it. So, and one of them...
He could do a radio show in Ocala if he wanted to.
Yeah. By the way, Jameis Winston says he's not going to go to the NFL
not
draft.
Not going to the NFL draft.
He tells me he must know he's got the deal done.
Well, but do you think he has an obligation...
Sort of,
to the NFL and to the fans of the NFL to go to that.
Yeah, I think he would. His agent's going to tell him, you're the number one guy. They're going to want to talk to you and see you walk on the stage or whatever.
But they don't get any compensation for going, except their contract eventually.
Not what.
Yeah, but the NFL's making money off of it. They're selling it as this big event and everything. Give them an appearance fee or something,
first
buddy.
Of all, I've always had a problem with them making an event out of it.
Oh, well, I know. That's a whole separate issue.
It's not something you keep scoring.
You remember when it was in the Miami Hilton and nobody paid attention to it.
Well, I mean, it was in New York for a long time. But, I mean, it's fine, but it's a hyped-up event. I mean, I get that people get stoked about it because all the hype that comes from ESPN. But Anyway, it is what it is. I just have to accept
that. Made for TV event.
Take a break, come back, and we'll talk to Franzberg, get his final four picks. I'm probably going to go with the four number one seeds.
You're going with the chalk. Probably you're just going to go with the chalk.
Well, the bottom line is, if you got your chalk players, have you got a better chance of survival?
By the way, chalk wins survival. A whole lot more than it loses.
Seems like it does. After this timeout on the Voice of Ocala, stay tuned to
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Guy Harvey Checking is now exclusively available at Gateway Bank. With Guy Harvey Checking, you will receive Gateway's premium checking account, plus several other Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation features, including membership to the Guy Harvey Hammerhead Nation, free Guy Harvey t-shirt, and an exclusive Guy Harvey debit card. At Gateway Bank, we will make a $50 donation to the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation for every new account opened. This is just one more reason why people choose Gateway Bank. Sign up today for your exclusive Guy Harvey Checking account with Gateway. Details available at gatewaybankcfl.com, member FDIC.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
Let's give it up for old asphalt and a new pair of shoes. Let's give it up for a good rhythm meeting a sweet melody. For a church cookout under clear skies. Let's give it up for good things coming together, like bundling your auto and other policies together with an Allstate agent, which can save you time and keep you better protected. Let's give it up for good.
To receive your comparative insurance quote, contact the McDonald Agency at 622-2333.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer. In everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and the car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
Johnny, what are you doing in the bathroom? What are you saying? Wait, where are your toy cars? Oh no, tell me you didn't. Honey, call Mike Scott Plumbing.
I didn't do anything.
For once, that's true, but little Johnny flushed his toys down the toilet and now it's broke.
Yes. I mean, oh no, I'll get the phone. What's the toll-free number?
866-314-4443.
Got it. 866-314-4443. 4443.
Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, they do it. At Mike Scott Plumbing, from the moment you walk through the doors, it's evident that quality is key. From our fully stocked parts department to our fully trained service technicians who can help with anything from a clogged drain to your irrigation system and even servicing your entire septic system. Visit one of our beautiful showrooms in Hernando or in Wildwood and let us show you how to turn your kitchen and bath dreams into reality. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
PPIR is a networking group formed to serve the realtor and small business community. It primarily serves the real estate and construction industry, but is open to all businesses that provide any service or product to the real estate business community. PPIR has no membership dues or fees for attendees. The watchwords are keep it simple and maximize networking time. PPIR chapters generally meet once a month after business hours. For the information on this, call 352-615-9412 or go to events at ppirevents.com. PPIR, professional people in real estate.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
In a study involving more than 2,000 people, those with slimmer waistlines showed higher cognitive ability than those who were overweight or obese. Our pets improve our character and make us much better people. If your partner's the one who's stressed out, we know that you will be 25% more likely to be affected than a stranger would be. Yeah, be careful because stress is contagious.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Back on the sports page, Buddy Martin. Tom and I are not paying much attention to the brackets. Let's get it on just for Kentucky and see if they play Duke or Wisconsin and see if anybody can beat Kentucky. That's what it's about. But a guy who does follow it closely, I'm sure he's got his brackets all figured out. And if you're wanting some advice, he'd probably give it to you. It's Franz Beard, FightGators.com, and he joins us on the program. Now, Franz, good to talk to you. Missed you last week. Had phone problems, and we didn't get a chance to get you on. So what's your overall view of the selection committee's work, and does anything jump out at you?
Well, two things jump out at me. One of them is Kentucky really has a good path to get to the national championship game, I mean to the Final Four, unbeaten. I don't see a lot of opposition for them till they get to the Final Four. I think Duke should not be a number one seed. How can you be a number one seed when you didn't win your conference regular season and when you didn't win your conference tournament over teams that did do that?
What I heard about that, Francis, they gave them credit for going on the road and playing teams like Wisconsin. They played good road games, and that the committee said it gave little or no attention to winners of conference championships. That's what they said.
Well, here's the deal: is Arizona had a higher RPI, won its conference championship, and won its conference championship tournament, and to me, that speaks volumes more than Duke. You know, I think Duke got in as the number one and got put in the South where there's not a lot of opposition for Duke. I don't see a lot there that merits Duke being a number one. Arizona should have been a number one in the West. Wisconsin should have been the number one in the South. UCLA should not be in, period. There is no excuse for that team to be in, to have as bad a record as they have against top 100 teams. They're 2-8 against the top 50 and barely, just a little bit better against the top 100 RPI.
But they're 11th seed. They're only 11th seed. They were 20-13, and so you think they shouldn't be in at all, huh?
I think they should be in an NIT team. Let me put it this way. With a better RPI is Colorado State, which won 27 ball games and had a better RPI. Colorado State should have been in there. There are other teams that should have been in there. There's a legitimate case. UCLA scored 7 points in the first half against Kentucky. Seven. And scored 42 in the game, got beat by 41, only because Calipari played his walk-ons the last 10 minutes of the game. Otherwise, it would have been a 100-point deficit, and Calipari would have been booed for pouring it on poor little old UCLA.
All right, so we don't have a Cinderella, do we?
Well, anybody that can beat Kentucky is going to be Cinderella.
Yeah, but nobody can. But nobody can.
Well, there's three teams that have a chance.
Wisconsin's got a chance.
Wisconsin has a chance.
Duke has a chance.
Duke has a chance if two things happen. Okafor has to be in the ballgame. If Okafor is not in the ballgame, Duke has no prayer. But if Okafor is in the ballgame and not worn down by Kentucky just running one seven-footer after another, and he's scoring, that means that Quinn Cook, that means that Tyus Jones, that means that Matt Jones are all going to be on the outside, and they're going to have a chance to hit shots. Arizona, because Arizona has two great athletic wings in Stanley Johnson, who's 6'7", 240, and yet he runs like a gazelle, and Rondi Hollis Jefferson, who can defend five positions on the court. They've got these two athletic freaks on the wings that can take away the perimeter. They got enough size in the middle that they can handle. They can handle Kentucky if they can stay out of foul trouble. That's the big thing, is Kentucky's got so much size, they can get you in foul trouble, and you're playing small while they're still playing big. Duke's the last team, as I mentioned before, Wisconsin, that runs a great offense. They're the most disciplined team in the tournament, and those guys are not going to be fazed if they get to the Final Four. They were there last year. You know, they should have beaten Kentucky last year in the semifinals. They just barely got beat. I think it was the last second shot, three by Aaron Harrison, that saved that. But those are the three teams that can do it. Now, you talked about Cinderella teams that can scare people and go a long way. Northern Iowa. Nobody wants to play Northern Iowa. I would not want to play Northern Iowa. Wichita State, another one of those teams that don't want to play. Davidson, another team. Davidson's got five guys that can shoot, and if they all get on at the same time, they're going to be tough for anybody to beat.
Franz Beard, talk with Franz Beard. Franz, Tom Schmitz here. I'm looking at four potential games in round two on the Saturday-Sunday matchups if everything holds the way it should. And one of them is the University of Northern Iowa and Louisville. That's going to be a great game. You got Virginia, Michigan State, if it holds true. You got North Carolina, Arkansas, if it holds true. But the game everybody will talk about, especially, in the state of Kansas anyway, because they could never get this game to pull off. The best number second game of the weekend, I think, is going to be Kansas-Wichita State, if it holds up.
That could really be a good ball game. I'll tell you one other team that I forgot to mention that I'm going to tell you what. Don't sleep on these guys. I don't care who you are, even if you're Kentucky, and that is Iowa State. I am the biggest Iowa State believer in the world. I've been watching them the last two weeks, and you know when they were down by 15 at the half to Kansas, I said, you know, my comment was they got Kansas exactly where they want them, and sure enough, they came back and beat them. This is one terrific ball club, and if you get them down, they don't panic. They run an NBA style of offense, and they will run no matter what, and by golly, they can score.
I agree with you. Iowa State looks good. The other team is Notre Dame, obviously impressed the heck out of everybody in the ACC. You mentioned it, Wichita State. I'm sure there's another team. One of the games I like is Michigan State Georgia first round matchup. Everybody's conceding that game to Michigan State. And Georgia's got a shot there, a 10-7 game. You know, got a shot.
Well, here's the thing with Georgia. If Kenny Gaines is playing, Georgia has a chance. They really have a chance. If Kenny Gaines is not playing, they really, really have a problem. Because Kenny has a 44-inch vertical leap. He's a guy that can give them minutes if they need against an athletic small forward. He can overpower guards his own size or even an inch or two taller. But he's kind of like their X factor, and he's a really good guy. But Georgia could win that game.
All right, Franz, thank you. We got to run. Franz Beard from FightGators.com. Stay tuned. More coming your way right here on The Source.
Time now to spiff up your bling for spring. Make your rings look brand new. Our master jeweler at Goss & Son will rhodium finish your rings for just $69.95, regular price $75. It's like waxing your car. It brings that shine back and looks all brand new all over again. So come see us, our downtown location, Goss & Son Jewelers, serving you downtown for 65 years.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says there will be no final vote on Loretta Lynch's nomination to be the next Attorney General unless Democrats help pass a measure that fights human trafficking.
There's not a single legitimate question that has been raised about her aptitude for this job. Instead, all we've seen is a bunch of political obstruction from Republicans.
White House spokesman Josh Earnest, Senate Democrats say the bill in question contains anti-abortion language and they won't vote on it till it's removed. Robert Durst, the Realty heir, suspected murderer and subject of an HBO serial about his life, is under arrest. An open mic caught him admitting to his crimes.
Durst waived his right to an extradition hearing and through his attorney said he is eager to go to Los Angeles.
Fox's John Roberts, Durst is wanted for murder in California. Wall Street had a good day. The Dow closed up 228 to finish at 17,978. The NASDAQ was up 58. The S&P climbed 27.5. Fox News. We report. You decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Calista Redmond, a veteran trailblazer and a technology leader, speaking about the open power server technology and how it is changing the world.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin will be in the studio in the garden with Carol Ann, taking your calls about your lawns and your gardens.
Have all of your real estate questions answered by Bob Kennedy on Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty with Bob Kennedy.
And then Joe Reichel from Damage Control Services will be answering your questions about your do-it-yourself home repair projects.
Seth Posner will be in the studio. He's the owner of AA Lock Dock and Security, security systems for businesses and individuals.
All of that, plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live, right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Oddly enough, although we've got the brackets going on in March Madness, it's football season for those of us who follow it closely, as we do here on this program and on Southern Pigskin tonight, heard every Thursday and Friday at 5 p.m. here on The Source. We'll be getting some reports in from some of our folks around the SEC. I'm going to pick up, probably talk to a reporter for the Georgia team. The Atlanta Journal-Constitution, Andy Johnson, will be joining us Wednesday. We'll see if we can get Robbie Andrew up for Gainesville, because today up in Gainesville, the University of Florida, the new head coach, Jim McElwain, began spring practice. And he's got a lot to look at. As I said, last week we had a chance to visit with Coach McElwain. He's an upbeat guy. I like how he approaches things, and I like the fact that he knows he's got the odds against him. I think he's the kind of guy that instantly makes you better when he walks in the room. I'm not saying he can perform a miracle or this team will automatically compete for an SEC championship. They're very thin in a lot of places that count, particularly offensive line, where they only have seven players. And you think that's a lot, but it's not, because today you need to have eight or nine almost offensive linemen. And then you've got the situation at linebacker. Antonio Morrison's hurt still. He's a key factor. He'll be back in the fall, but not in the spring. They're going to have to find some more linebackers. And, by the way, they do have a terrific secondary, learning, led by Vernon Hargraves III, another year, and some really good players back there. So the question is he going to pick Will Grier or is he going to pick Treon Harris? Based on what I've seen, I haven't really seen Will Grier, so it's not really fair to him. I'd say that the upper hand goes right now to the guy who's played. And Treon, that would be Treon Harris. But then again, I don't know what Coach McElwain wants out of his quarterbacks or what kind of offense he's going to run, presumably the pistol, which is what he ran up in Colorado State. And it's a little bit different because that's the running back behind him, the quarterback. We'll see what happens. I really look forward to seeing this team play in a spring game, although he says he didn't plan to play a traditional spring game. But you can get an idea, Tom, by watching a team perform a little bit on the field. Kind of an idea of whether they're throwing and catching the ball, whether the timing's any good. If they look like a football team, and as he said, right now I'm worried about whether they can get out of the huddle or not. So there's a lot of work to be done in Gainesville, but today Jim McElwain kicking it off.
Yeah, I don't know if you can read anything into this. I'm looking at the report Thomas Goldkamp of GatorBait.com.net put up out on the web, and it says the offensive line, the first team unit from left to right, was David Sharp, Antonio Riles, Cameron Dillard, Andrew Mike, and Roderick Johnson. And that when you got the quarterbacks, buddy, they only did a very light work today, throwing through the route tree in the second session of practice. But Will Grier took the first snap of walkthrough work, while he and Skylar Morningweg took the reps with the first team offensive line and the walkthrough work. Treon Harris repped exclusively with the second team during walkthrough. I don't know if you can put any stock in that, what that means. It's just the first day. But it seems a little odd to me that Treon Harris would be sent to the second team and Skylar Morningweg would be taking first team reps.
Yeah, that doesn't sound right. And, of course, it's a little hard to distinguish what the first and second team is for the most part, but I'll take Thomas Goldkamp's word for it. We'll see why that was. Who knows? Maybe Treon Harris is hurt. I don't know.
Right. First-team defensive line appears to be Jonathan Bullard, Joey Ivey, Tavon Bryan, and Alex McAllister. And, you know, McAllister's a pretty good defensive end.
Yeah.
And that's
– Well, so is Bullard, by the way.
Right. And other notes, I don't know why players do this. Maybe you have some insight on this. But several players have changed their name. Brandon Powell went from 20 to number 4. Quincy Williams went from 12 to 6.
Changed their number, you mean?
Right.
Well, Brandon Powell's now a wide receiver.
Right, but he went from 20 to 4. He could have wore 20 as a wide receiver, couldn't he?
No.
But Quincy Wilson went from 12 to 6 as a cornerback. DeAndre Porter went from 21 to 15 as a cornerback. Matt Rowland from 9 to 25 as a linebacker, and Jalen Tabor from 5 to 31 as a cornerback. So I don't know. Why do kids change numbers like that?
Well, because they can, and because they have numbers that are given up and their new numbers available to them and whatever. I'm with Scott Brantley on one thing. I hate seeing linebackers with single digits on them. I just don't like it. But that's how it is today. So.
Well, the last note before we go to break, Daniel, and I never can say his name right, buddy. Amatari Habatibi or something. The wide receiver that came in.
Spell it.
Imatorbhebhe.
I got no clue.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, Thomas Goldkamp said he has terrific size, look fluid and drill with quarterbacks throwing the route tree against air.
Yeah, the problem he has, though, is he leans. He leans backwards because his name is so big.
It holds him back. Well, it says he made several nice catches, showed good feet work and footwork. So maybe, you know, we've all known that for the last few years, the wide receiving core at Florida has been a little suspect.
I think they got the right guy. If you watch
Colorado State. Oh, tight end. He's a tight end, by the way.
Colorado State, if you watch them play last year, and I did, they are well coached at their pass game. So that's one thing I expect the new coaches to be able to handle that and without a problem. So Nussmeier included. Let's take a break. Come back. We'll get Joe Williams' take on the brackets. Tom and I are still trying to figure them out. I think Tom's got one set that shows Notre Dame winning them all.
Yeah, beating Virginia.
I don't believe Tom's going to submit that one anywhere, however. But we'll see. We'll take a break and return to Buddy Sports Page after this timeout on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
When you were a kid, you had all sorts of toys. Toy cars, boats, trucks, entire toy boxes full of fun. Of course, you never really outgrow your toys, do you? It's just that now, instead of a box full, you have a garage full. Cars, trucks, boats, motorcycles, ATVs, and more. As you get older, your love of toys just gets stronger. So protect those toys the best way possible by switching to Allstate. An Allstate agent can help do the switching, paperwork, bundle all your policies together, and even find you a bunch of discounts. So if you love your toys, make sure you protect your toys by making one call to an Allstate agent.
Protect all your toys with Allstate and the McDonald Agency. Established in 1985, we have offices in Ocala and the Villages to better serve you. Give us a call at 622-2333. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability.
Are you in good hands?
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer. In everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlett's Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball.
Are you a mom looking for inspiration? Are you creative? Mamazine.com is a lifestyle blog designed for the local mom to be inspired by the beauty of motherhood while staying current on local events and issues. Visit Mamazine.com today to find events around town, recipes, imaginative play ideas, and more. Mamazine.com.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com. Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust-proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money?
Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
To get a hold of Joe Williams by High Sports. Meanwhile, kind of a strange story out of Tampa. The Tampa Bay Bucks apparently sent out a flyer this week, according to the Tampa Bay Times, that said in their release that one of the players they're looking at is Marcus Mariota. Now, look, we understand how when you're trying to sell tickets, you want to use all you can use. But you look at that and you think, maybe this thing's not a given. And then the story comes out about Jameis Winston, who most people think will be the number one pick overall, planning not to attend the 2015 NFL draft, saying he prefers to spend that day with his family and friends in Alabama, according to his father. So apparently that's not set in stone, according to one of the ESPN says, but he said he doesn't plan right now to go to Chicago. So we'll see what happens there with Jameis Winston. I still feel like, and most people do, there's something going on with Philadelphia. Why they could take Fitzgerald at quarterback already, and Mariota, you know, and they made the deal naturally for trade Foles away for. And the question is going to be now, will in fact he give Tim Tebow a real look, which is what they're reporting. Tim Tebow is now working out or plans to try out with the Eagles. That's interesting. A lot of people think there's still something deeper than that, that maybe Chip Kelly is going to pull a deal off. Maybe Sam Bradford's bait for something else. And people start speculating that what would that be? You aren't going to get a number one pick, I don't think, for Sam Bradford. So if you're going to put something together and make a bid to get Mariota, which would make the most sense, by the way, to trade a player, because they've gotten rid of a lot of players and they have somehow wound up with a pretty good draft by getting Murray from the Cowboys or with a good, let's say, free agency, and the trades they made. But, boy, the players he's gotten off that, go off that team the last 2 years, amazing. These guys were terrific football players. You wonder what Chip Kelly's thinking and whether or not he still has a way to pull off the deal that would bring in Marcus Mariota, which is what we all know he wants to do. It'll be very interesting.
I talked about it with the SI. SI put out a article over the weekend that showed all the things Chip Kelly had done, and he had let Jeremy Maclin go. He had brought in a linebacker, Alonzo, who was injured his first year in the league. Now he's brought in Sam Bradford,
Buffalo linebacker is a terrific looking player right now.
Well, he was, but he was injured his first year.
They think he's going to be better, and apparently he's a great prize. He led the team in tackles, so they got hurt.
Right, but they're still. You never know what a person comes back after they've been hurt. No. Sam Bradford was the number one overall pick and rookie of the year, but, you know, offensive rookie of the year, but nobody's saying he's the next Tom Brady or Peyton Manning because he gets hurt too often.
Well, all we don't know about Sam Bradford, and this is the thing that's puzzling. You've seen Bradford play. I saw him play. Florida played Oklahoma for the national championship. Bradford gets the ball out quick. He's got quick hands, fairly quick feet. What I know of Chip Kelly's offense, could you see Sam Bradford running that offense at Oregon? I could not.
First of all, it would be a different offense because they don't run the ball in Philadelphia like they did at Oregon. But it seems to me, when you think about quarterbacks fitting a system, unless I'm missing something, I don't see how, other than getting a quick release, getting up quick outs, you know, taking the three-step drop, I don't see how Sam Bradford fits into Kelly's offense. But obviously, he knows that a lot better than I do. So,
well, in this article, I'm trying to find it, that Sports Illustrated did over the weekend, Chip Kelly talked about how he fits perfectly into his offense, because if he can get back to where he can make the first read and then run a little bit, he thinks Sam Bradford's perfect for what he does.
He's not going to run.
I don't think so either.
How could a quarterback who's already been injured be running the football in the zone read? I mean, yeah, once a game maybe, but come on.
I agree. I thought it was – I don't know. But as I said on Saturday, Chip Kelly's a lot smarter at what he does than we are. And he has a plan. And that's what the NFL is about, buddy. You have a plan, you execute your plan, and then either it works or it don't work, and you're either a genius or you're fired. I mean, it's one way or the other. That you know, on a week-by-week basis, if a coach – and let's be honest, they're all smarter than we are when it comes to coaching and decision-making like that. And either it works or it don't work, and either he's a genius or he's out of a job. Bill Belichick wasn't thought of as too good a coach when he was in Cleveland, and now he's the genius of the NFL.
See, I don't buy that, because even Bradshaw says this, and we've had other people tell us on this program – the coaches make mistakes.
I didn't say they don't make mistakes. And I just said they're smarter than we are about these things.
Well, this is the myth that they're automatically smarter than all of us. And yeah, certain things, they know the game better, but sometimes they take two and two and make five out of it.
Well,
and
remember,
sometimes two and two ain't five, and you can look at case histories of coaches who make decisions that were wrong. Now, look, if I got a coach, I want him to have the guts to make those decisions and maybe be wrong. It's okay to be wrong. But just because Chip Kelly has proven to be, you know, one of the smarter coaches, doesn't mean he couldn't be making a big mistake.
Oh, no, and he could be making – look, there was plenty – when Bill Belichick brought in Chad Ochocinco, that was a big mistake, you know. That mistakes are made by coaches all the time. Here's one thing I do know. In Chip Kelly's tenure in the NFL, which has been very short, he's led the league both years in one category that tells you a lot about why he brings in Sam Bradford and why he brings in Kiko Alonso. Most time on the field by starters, Philadelphia leads the league in least injuries that cost field time to players. And that maybe he's got some conditioning or got a good group of conditioners, but all I know is the last 2 years in a row, whether it be luck or conditioning, Philadelphia's had less injuries to starters than any other team in the league.
Well, they've had a key start. They had key people hurt, though. They've had quarterbacks hurt. They've had running backs hurt.
Compared to the rest of the league, they're the best.
Maybe it could be. All right, that's a stat. DeMarco Murray got a bum deal, in my opinion. He really did.
He only had one good year, buddy.
Yeah, but he carried the ball. He was the pack mule last year.
Yes.
Look, and I heard Michael Irvin say this today, and I agree with him. What kind of a message does it send to your locker room when you take a veteran player, run him in the dirt, and then let him go? And you know, where is the, you know, talk about loyalty, there is none. But, I mean, the fact is the players know that. The players see that. The rest of the guys who play hard, say, hey, what about me?
They offered him $6.5 million a year.
I understand that, but they did not feel him make him feel welcome. By the way, Ndamukong Suh also said today he would love to have stayed in Detroit. Of course, you can say that now. Detroit would have probably come close to matching that money. But the fact remains is that – and today Butch Wilfork signed a two-year deal, $9 million.
Where did Vince Wilfork go?
Vince Wilfork, of course, is cut. He went to the Texans. And what kind of decision is that? One quick note. The Los Angeles Raiders in their heyday made a living off of bringing older players back and getting an extra 3 or 4 years out of
them. You're right.
They had great camaraderie.
Can you imagine just what it just popped in my head. If Vince Wilfork can give them half of what he did in New England, him clogging up the middle, and if Jadeveon Clowney comes back healthy, Watt on one side, Jadeveon Clowney on the other side.
They might make a yard.
Quarterbacks are going to be – they're going to be quarterbacks and running backs with nightmares.
You're right. That's a great – that might be as good a defensive line as there is in football.
Wow.
Of course, whoever depends on – plays on each other side of Dominican Sue might be also pretty good too.
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, anyway, that's got football. We didn't get to tell Joe Ways. We'll reach Joe Ways tomorrow. I want to thank our guests we did have, of course, Brad Rogers in the first hour, Franz Beard, who gave us some information that we didn't have on the brackets. Tom and I got nothing. Brackets, smackets. Maybe tomorrow we'll have something. So on behalf of my broadcast partner, Tom Spitz, I am Buddy Martin. Thanks for listening. Have a wonderful night, everybody.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Hello, I'm Tom Schmitz, here to tell you about Okus, a great resource for any business and a proud partner of the CEP. Okus offers your business radically new technology called next-generation websites. Sites that do not wear out, they automatically adapt to new technology like smartphones, tablets, and the next big thing. Why pay for technology that starts becoming obsolete the moment you buy it? With Okus, there is so much more. Built into the Okus platform is an unmatched array of business solutions adaptable to any business. Okus is a superb example that cutting-edge technology can grow prosper in Marion County. And I should know because they handle my website, ktforfun.com. Okus has assisted numerous companies in Marion County that have succeeded online. You can learn more by visiting them online at okus.com. That's OCOOS.com. Or drop by their downtown Ocala location at 116 South Magnolia Avenue. Find out how Okus can provide your business with everything you need to succeed online.
Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
This is James Snyder inviting you to join me each Sunday morning at 9:30 for Sunday Joy, right here on WOCA 1370.
You're listening to WOCA Ocala. Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 13.